mark a steady rise in Georgia's economy. Once central to the former Soviet Union's development and manufacture of weapons, Georgia has recently resurfaced as a potential player in the world military industry, with active contracts in Russia, Turkey, Germany, and even has stated the need, especially in these times, for a reliable source of oil in the Middle East. Commerce Secretary Moore, on a visit to Azerbaijan this morning, noted the tiny nation's enormous potential for oil, calling on American investors to provide the necessary funds for tapping the reserves.
In many ways, a leader from a bygone era. His beliefs are very firmly founded in Georgian orthodoxy. His political standings more in line with the early 20th century.
Would you fault him then as a politician?
No, no, not at all. Kombayn Nikoladze is all politician. He's done wonders for the Georgian economy. A brilliant tactician. It's more a question of ethics.
And ethically speaking?
Well...
Georgian Defense Ministry, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 16th, 2004, 23:01 hours. Discover President Nikoladze's secret. CIA agents Blaustein and Madison were killed for getting too close to information Georgian President Kombayn Nikoladze needed to protect. Vyacheslav Grinko, a Russian mercenary, is closely tied to Nikoladze's secret. They have arranged to meet at the Ministry of Defense. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell and First Person Perspective. Just like the previous video, this one is also a post-gameplay voiceover. Primarily because the commentary that I did while playing turned out to be pretty low quality, and thankfully I used two audio channels so that I can always, you know, isolate the commentary track from the gameplay soundtrack. So that works out in my favor, I guess. But anyhow, right now Sam just found out in the previous mission that Blaustein and Madison were killed for the investigation into the Georgian president. And now he's at the Ministry of Defense looking into his accomplice, Vyacheslav Grinko, and how the two are connected and the kind of conspiracy that they're working together to cover up. So, yeah, without further ado, let's go and get this.
Echelon got a positive ID on your target from the morgue security cameras. A guy named Vyacheslav Grinko.
How do I find him?
By his license plate.
And if he's not with his car?
Then his driver will be. Grab him and make him talk. Don't be afraid to use force.
Who? Me?
So...
Grim's daughter just pulled up the schematics on the ministry. They've got a laser security grid online in the courtyard.
So I stay out of the courtyard.
Don't let them trigger any alarms at all. We still don't have any official approval from the Joint Chiefs for this operation. So one slip up and it's mission over.
So as you guys can see, there's like a grid of lasers in the courtyard down there, which we need to deactivate first. So anyway, right now I'm wondering whether I should, you know, take the conventional path of traveling down the, you know, window, or whether I should try something new and exciting by jumping into the balcony below me. And guess which path I choose. You don't have to guess, you're gonna see, find out in a few anyway. But yeah, that's basically what I'm learning right now. What sucks is that, I like doing live voiceovers. For one, it saves me a lot of time, and two, it just feels more natural with, you know, the events of the game. But anyhow, here we are. So, yeah, we're trying to basically, you know, jump down there, but things aren't always as easy as they seem. This actually took me like 4 or 5 attempts to try this, and as you can see, Sam is very reluctant to, you know, just jump over this ledge here, because you're not meant to do that. But this is basically one of the ways you can exploit the game mechanics and make life just a little bit easier for yourself. And I'm guessing this is the opening that they wanted you to exploit when, you know, to get past this room without knocking this guard out, although I am certain that there are other ways to do it as well. But anyway, this is one of the things that I was telling you about when, you know, I was talking about how this mod can be immersion breaking at times. Like, you can just see through the door without even having to use a snake cam. And you can peek through cover as well. Luckily, I was in the shadows here, so this guy did not notice me. And I don't believe this mod also makes it more difficult for others to spot you. I don't know how it makes you move silent as well, despite whatever it says. We're in the shadows under this camera, and we're all safe. We're good to go. I honestly could not believe that I pulled this off, and yeah, here we are. I mean, we're completely safe right now, in the shadows, past this section, without a single, you know, knockout, which is something which I've never been able to do before, but oh well. Yeah, the rest of the, you know, excursion follows standard procedure. We head downstairs with avoiding cameras, and there's like this, you know, stick to the shadows, wait until the cameras are looking away from you, then get under them, because that is the practically the only place where they cannot see you at all. And yeah, just like that. Actually, you can do it further. I did it pretty slow. Just listen to the amount of sound you know, Sam is making, despite the fact that he's crouched running at full speed right now. Honestly, I think that if this mod was not installed, Sam would be making a lot more noise. But I'm guessing that this mod actually ends up making the footsteps more silent. If it does not, then I'm presuming that it actually, you know, it is supposed to make them noisier, but for some or the other glitch in my system, it's making them more silent, in my case at least. That's the way to the exit. Actually, that's the way we exit via. Not the way to the exit, that's the way from the exit. The way we used to make our escape. Anyhow, this game looks so pretty, like with or without the night vision, and sometimes I feel like sort of an ass for like keeping the night vision on all the time, even though it, you know, enables you to see better. But yeah, like I don't need to quick save as much as I do, but I'm just being cautious here, force of habit. I mean, I tried playing the game on the PS2 once. Actually, it was an emulator, PS2 emulator, PCSX2. But god damn, that changes the entire game. I mean, without the quick saves, it becomes such a different experience.
What the hell?
I'm going to ask you some questions. When I think you're lying, I'll do this. Who do you work for?
Vyacheslav Grinko.
Tell me about him.
He used to be Spetsnaz. Now he's mercenary. He works for President Nikoladze.
Where do I find Grinko?
He's meeting Masse in the elevator by the courtyard.
Who's Masse?
Philippe Masse, some computer guy. He has access to Nikoladze's office.
What's this meeting about?
I don't know. I swear, it's gotta be something bad if Nikoladze is willing to see Grinko face to face.
I need you to understand that we never talked.
I understand.
Good.
I want to hear what Grinko and Masse talk about in that elevator.
I'll need to deactivate the courtyard laser grid.
I mean,
in
the
position.
View is pretty
then
intimate.
Do it.
You know, like. Just look at how demanding Lambert is. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's nothing Sam can't handle, but yeah. Talk about a boss, you know? So anyway, yeah, I mean, minus the quick saves that you get on the PC version, the game runs drastically different. I mean, on the PS2, it was initially such a shock to have to, you know, retry checkpoints all the way from the beginning, just because, you know, I initially thought about shooting this guy, but then I decided not to shoot this guy. And I think what I was just playing here was how this mod, you know, just squeezes your reticle down into that's at the center there and does not let it spread at all, which is typically what you would expect from one of the,
I heard something.
Not one of the older trilogy of Splinter Cell. I mean, they didn't intend for these games to be shooters, and as a result, the reticle just, you know, expands with the lightest of movements. Like, unless you're moving the mouse really slow or the, you know, right analog stick really slow, the reticle would expand instantaneously, clear up. So yeah, anyway, like, On the consoles, the game is such a drastically different experience to play. I mean, yeah, PS2 more basic graphics, and even like the level design is quite changed to accommodate for the interior, design specifications. But despite all of that, simple fact that you can't save whenever you want, or you can't even quick save. It's such a game changer because you have to like literally retry the sections over and over again, and in a sense it leads you to perfection. This is where you go, that platform up top, that's where you, I think, you get a medikit and I think a disposable pick as well, if I'm not wrong. I haven't been there in a long time, but you can actually, perform some acrobatics and get up there. A reward isn't anything too significant though. But one of the things about the first game are all of these extra areas that are just lying around, which you can access, which you can actually access, or at least you take a look at them and it feels like you can access these extra areas. But yeah, not really. I mean, some of the areas are pretty much just trolls, and some of the areas are, they will actually fetch you something, give you something value. And I guess it was just the trend of video games back in that day where they decided to make them more exploratory and not just, a simple run from point A to point B. Because even in this game, you have to figure out quite a lot of things. Things such as, where to go, what to do next. They aren't always just, given to you on a silver platter. You need to, as much as you need to do the legwork, you need to do the brain work as well. So, is that correct term for the brain work? I don't know. Let me know what the correct term is. And yeah, that was easy spy. I mean, it looked easy spy on the video, but I actually had to struggle with that a little because unless your timing is very precise, it's not going to be that easy to distract that guy and make it to the other side. And judging by the sound that Fisher made when he right before he entered the shadows, I'm guessing that you can do the crouch roll thing in this game as well.
I need a colonel down here. We're trying to get through a retinal scanner.
I passed Colonel Kibashvili on my patrol. Want me to send him down?
God, no. I hate this guy. We'll find somebody else with the lamp.
Colonel Kobayashvili, the man universally hated. So yeah, one of the few differences that I noticed between the PS2 version and this version of this map was that in the PS2 version there's like this vent up there, which you typically use to get directly into the fuses section right over there. And
may I? Please.
Yeah. In contrast, in this game.
Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah, so in the PS2 version, you actually exit in the freezer section of the of this area, and not, you don't actually get to climb in through the window. They notice you if you do, I think, or maybe you just can't. Maybe you just fall over. And it's stuff like this which really breaks the immersion of the first person mod. It does, don't get me wrong, it makes the game easy as well without, having to enter a third person peek. But you can literally peek through the entire, cabinet right there. And I'm actually trying something rather, bold and experimental here. But this is a different sort of a play. I'm surprised to find myself in the shadows at this juncture. I'm going to try and sneak past this guy without knocking him out. So I look at him, going back on his patrol, and I decide to move up and wait for him. Because the next time he comes over and turns his back to us, I plan on, well, shadowing him. Now, one of the things that this mod does is it makes it much easier to sneak up on people or sneak behind people, since, you know, your footsteps are more silent, as far as I've seen. So, one of the bad things about this mod is if you need to knock somebody out by grabbing them from behind, that becomes a challenge, since, this is like a very fine line. You'll see that in the CIHQ video that I did. There's like a very fine line between bumping into them and, being able to grab them. And you can't really accurately gauge the distance because you're in first person and you need to, practically get right into the object that you're trying to interact with before you can. But this is one of the reasons why I say that this mod makes you less noticeable. Is because typically whenever I've tried that without this mod installed, it has turned out that people, when they get too close to me, they always notice me. With this mod, that seems to be, just thrown out of the window. A lot like Chaos Theory, where you also have a system built in where, you can actually get behind a person or near a person without actually bumping into them, which I personally like quite a bit. And one of the things is that I noticed when I'm playing this game is that I've certainly improved, because I wouldn't have been able to land a crouch from a jump like that before. But anyway, we need to get rid of this guy here because there's literally no other way around it. And once we do, we hack into the computer, not hack into the computer, we use the computer, and then use the Colonel's eyes. Kobayashvili's eyes to gain entry to the next area. Now, after we knock this guy out, we just wait for the Colonel.
You've got an incoming Colonel, Fisher. Make the most of him. You'll need him conscious and cooperative if you want to unlock the retinal scanner sealing the door to the courtyard.
That's detailed intelligence.
Knowing everything is my job.
It's just one of the, few things that made the banter in these games, so charming, so to speak, like gave them a sense of charm. And apparently the Colonel uses different paths to come down, depending on whether you knock people out or not. And I've actually never... this one time when I did knock somebody out, upon the top floor, I noticed him coming down from this side. So that's why I've always waited on this side for him ever since. But he never comes down from that, this side anymore. He always comes down from the other side. And, I don't know how it works, to be honest. But I just find it weird that it is so. Anyway, the ending of this level, because they, sort of force an encounter on you, it's a good opportunity to show how effective. So if you see me pausing like that randomly, it's probably because, as I'm recording this, the video seems to be stuttering quite a lot, and I don't know what's wrong. Maybe it's just, my PC's overloaded or something. Or maybe, the encoder is going all wonky, or rather the decoder. But yeah, that's what it is. The video is lagging on my end, so... I've got to take that out. Actually, I'll just keep that in. I don't mind that. So anyway, just to be... by the end of this video, since they practically force you into an encounter, it'll be a good testament to just how powerful this mod is. I mean, just from this alone, you can gauge how powerful it is, because, as long as you have something in the center of your crosshairs, your bullet's going good. And that is not how this game always is. I mean, even glass if you have something in your crosshairs, your bullet can typically stray here, or there. But what this mod, one of the things that this mod does is...
Why did you rip it out with pliers?
We had some difficulty with Blaustein's ship. You can see fibers of muscle tissue still attached.
On it.
Nasty.
You're in the wrong line kind of work to avoid getting gore on your hands.
Whatever Nikoladze does in Azerbaijan is his own conscience's burden.
You are just a tool?
You're a tool. I'm the technology. I'm the cleanup man. All the blood's on yours and Nikoladze's hands. I'm clean.
And it is?
It's what?
Clean.
Azerbaijan? Yeah, man. The operation's goddamn immaculate. Except for the files. Nikoladze insists on keeping on his own machine. You need to talk to that.
Sounds like we found the subdermals.
I get nervous when the bad guys start making blood jokes.
That conversation's going straight to the Joint Chiefs, and we're gonna need more.
Nikoladze's computer.
You guessed it. Get inside his office and access that machine. Alarms aren't mission critical anymore. We're moving into Fifth Freedom territory.
Oh, yeah. So, anyway, what was I saying now? Anyway, like, moving on, that conversation between them actually led us to discover that there is something going on in Azerbaijan. And we need more, as much evidence as we can get, aside from, you know, just two people being chatty. A disposable pick. Now, typically I don't like exploring game mechanics, but since I've played this game to hell and back, actually I haven't played that much, but yeah, I've played this game quite a lot. So, I mean, I don't mind exploiting the, you know, door clip through mechanic for this game at least. And it would be the same for Pandora Tomorrow and Chaos Theory as well. I just wish that they would release a first-person mod for Double Agent as well. But I guess Ubisoft moved on to using Unreal Engine 3.5 at that point in time. Or maybe 2.5, no, I guess it was 3.5. And yeah, you could no longer mod the games as easily. Now, here's what I was talking about. I mean, you really need to get right up into whatever you're trying to interact with. Was that a medikit there? I think there was a medikit on the shelf there. I mean, you guys can probably rewind and check for yourselves. But yeah, I missed it. There was something glowing there. Anyway, yeah, this section also exemplifies one of the problems with this mod, and that's that you don't know where you're going. I mean, unless you're looking at your feet, you don't know where you're standing. So, anyway, we finally got up. So, if you look in the other direction, you'll realize that the same duct that brought you here actually takes you over into this like coffee room, like a waiting room full of soldiers. Yeah. A break room rather, and the other side of the vent takes you right into the break room. And this is a fine example of how, no matter how much help you have, if you suck at shooting stuff, you will keep missing, no matter what. So anyway, there's another medkit here. I mean, I wouldn't really need that many medkits if, you know, this mod makes the gun as accurate as it does. Did I just notice Sam's teeth there? Huh. I guess I did. Anyway, so, and right now I'm trying to figure out how you, you know, do the inverted rappel and whether that's a... I don't think you do rappel at all in Chaos Theory, like, not as a part of game mechanics anyway. But, I mean, I guess you can't do the inverted rappel here. But look at that accuracy. And the rest of the mission is pretty straightforward. I mean, typically I would hang off the ledge back there and hide, but Like how this approach to that, I mean, this is stealth shooting in the end. Sorry, tactical shooting mode in the end. So I will be shooting these people tactically. And it actually poses you with a huge advantage.
They've had commandos at work in Azerbaijan for weeks. How the hell did we miss this? Keep transmitting.
Alert! All men to full alert! We have an intruder in Nikolaj's office! Wake up, you bastard! I want troops in there now!
Grinko, sir. I've got three men about to brief Nikolaj's office.
Search the area.
Yeah, it's like so convenient when you already know what's gonna happen to, you know, gain the drop on your enemy. And despite that, I suck at shooting and I botched the job, damaging myself in the process. Well, actually, my enemies damaged me, but same thing. Probably could have taken this title as well, which I do now. Anyway.
That's the end of it, thank God.
What exactly is going on?
You wouldn't believe the numbers. Nikoladze has been systematically murdering his way through Azerbaijan.
And we didn't know about it.
Nobody did.
What does he want?
You can watch the news later. Rendezvous with Junior
Who's
Willis
there?
For extract.
What the? That's weird.
Yeah, this is like this, you know, one guy who comes in, comes back inside the office to check on everything. After the second time around that you hit the computer. And this is one guy who begins patrolling the stairwell area downstairs, you know, our exit path. So we kill him. Because this is a tactical shooter mod. And this is one of the examples of how relentless Sam Fisher can be. Actually, no, I'm just kidding.
Nikolaj's office is clear!
Sam Fisher isn't shown to be that relentless in one of these earlier games. And I don't know whether it is my greed or what, but I seem to think of a lot of medikits. And as you can see here, it's still pretty difficult to jump and grab that pipe over there. And those shots are by Vernon Wilkes Jr., who is taking care of him. I don't know why I'm walking so stealthily right now. But anyway,
what the hell did you find in there, man? Lambert's flipping out big time.
What's he saying?
That we're going to war.
Georgian Defense Ministry, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 17, 2004, 0051 hours. Files retrieved from President Nikoladze's computer reveal a campaign of terror against Azerbaijan. Covering their invasion using techniques of information warfare, cells of Georgian commandos have nearly overthrown their oil-rich neighbor. It's always about oil, isn't it? This intelligence has opened the door for NATO intervention in the Caucasus. Not to get controversial, but you know, like with America's war on Iraq for oil, this sort of seems, you know, like a thing of competing interests more than it seems like a thing of peace. But anyway, moving beyond that, so basically we broke into Nikoladze's office in the, you know, defense ministry. I don't know what he's why he has an office in there, because, well, he's supposed to be the president. I don't know if presidents have like offices in every single ministry out there or not. But anyway, it is what it is. We got information about how they were terrorizing, you know, people and just killing civilians in Azerbaijan. Or is it Azerbaijan? I don't know how to pronounce that name. Anyway, it's a proper noun, so I guess that doesn't really matter either. So basically, our attention has turned towards Nikoladze, and this seems to be grounds for war. I mean, they are already raging war against the neighbors, but I suppose America wants to intervene in the name of world peace as well. So, with that being said, that is enough for today's video. I shall see you guys soon. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.